Hey, everybody, I'm Kristen Hostetter with Snooze. Welcome to another episode of First Look. My guest today is Danny Giovalli. He is the founder and president of Cutula. How are you today, Danny?
Good. Thanks for having me, Kristen. How are you?
I'm doing great. It's a little strange to be talking about winter traction here. It's still practically summer, but it's going to be here before we know it. So,
yep, it sure will.
So you guys are really excited about the new ExoSpikes, I hear, the latest in the Cutula line. Tell me a little bit about the ExoSpikes and what makes them different from the other traction devices that you have.
We're well known for the MicroSpikes, and we've been more well known for the NanoSpikes lately for road running. But ExoSpikes is this really nice crossover between the two. So you've got the durability and lighter weight of the NanoSpikes, but a build that's more for a trail, handles some pavement and road as well. But it's just like that perfect mix of lighter weight, but very, very versatile. So it's kind of like our best all-around product.
This category of winter traction has certainly been growing over the last decade or so. But I think a lot of people still think of these products like they're crampons, right? And that they're only really necessary for mountaineering. They might think, why do I need traction? I'm not climbing K2. But really, anyone who lives in a cold climate would benefit from some type of winter traction, right?
It's kind of one of those experiences where once you start using a traction product like ours, you realize like what you're capable of doing. You actually modify your behavior because you think, well, I'm just gonna wait till tomorrow for that run or hike, or I'll wait till it warms up. Once you start having the ability to go out in all these conditions, you start expanding what you can do. So it's one of those things where once you experience it, you realize what you've been missing out on.
Yeah, and I really like the idea of kind of finding that middle ground between a more aggressive spike and then the lightweight ones, because do you pretty much put a pair of these on your winter boots and leave them by the door and leave them on all winter? It's like they can kind of just live on your boots, right?
I personally just keep them in my car all the time because you just never know when you're going to have that problem or an opportunity to go for a hike after work when you, if you don't have the traction, like you're not going to do it. So I just keep them in my car all the time in the winter.
Yeah, I have to tell you, I spent a lot of time in Vermont in the winter, and I've had the opportunity to test lots of different brands and products in this category. And one of the things that I love about Cutula is the harness system. And I've had a lot of problems with other harness systems. I really like the Cutula system because it wraps up way up around the top and toe and almost over the instep of the shoe. And I've never lost one yet. And so I think that's something that really stands out with your products.
Thanks for that. I appreciate it. We put a lot of time and effort into optimizing that. You know, the easy design solution is to put an additional strap over the top to try to lock it down. And that's just a bunch more stuff and things you have to deal with. When you look at our products, they look deceptively simple. And there's a tremendous amount of design that's gone into testing all the ways that it does not work in order to get to that place where it totally works. So it's appreciated. Thank you.
So Danny, tell me, how many models now are in the line? And again, maybe kind of walk through each one quickly, where each one falls in position and in their ideal use.
Yeah, right. I mean, really for our traction line, we're looking at three stretch over the shoe products and then the hiking crampons. And so, you know, if we kind of start from the smaller spiked nano spikes, that was our first foray into the carbide with the TPU cleat, you know, does not wear out on pavement and whatnot. So that's a great road running thing. And it's also a short spike, so you can run on hard surfaces and not wear your foot out. Now, that's a short spike, so it's not going to dig into the trail as much when you're on the steep trail. And so that steps you up to the Exo spikes, which we talked about just briefly a minute ago. And those have that larger cleat, but still the build with the carbide cleat and more of a tall TPU lug. So that digs into the trail, but also is very light. And then you go up to the micro spiked, which is that stainless steel build, hardened spikes, welded chains. And it's just like super burly, indestructible, bites into rocks and every type of mountainous terrain. If you go beyond that, you're getting into the hiking crampons, still for flexible footwear, still you can move fast and hike, but longer points. We're in the 1-inch range for spikes. And so people who are really getting into steeper mountain stuff, but not technical.
Which one sells the most? What's your best seller?
Microspikes is hands down the breadwinner right now. Nanospikes is actually doing really well. People are starting to realize the user-friendly nature of that and the everyday use for that. But Exospikes has just hit the market, right? We're looking at 1 month ago. And so that is brand new and I'm super excited about it.
What can retailers who stock winter traction do to educate their customers on why they might need them or ultimately seduce them into buying them?
I think that's a great question. And I do, and it goes back to this whole kind of quality of life and expanding what you're able to do. To me, if you're not careful, people have the mindset of, oh, it's just traction. Like, what's the cheapest one I can get? They're not thinking about the fact that if you have durable, well-designed traction, the amount of additional hikes, more miles, not to mention when you are doing those hikes, you're gonna be more comfortable and you're just cruising. Suddenly you're now looking up, enjoying your outing. You're gonna go farther. You're gonna feel more confident.
And it's not just about the spikes underfoot, right? You guys also do gaiters to kind of create a whole system.
Yeah, that's right. You really want to use the lightest footwear you can with a gaiter. So, you know, we've got a whole line of gaiters. Our Instigators are the most trim one for more the runner type user, and then all the way up to the full-blown Gore-Tex taller gaiter. But you close up that gap and you have waterproof footwear and then you have traction on your feet. You've kind of got like the whole system now. You're feeling warm, comfortable, confident. And that really opens up a lot of opportunities.
Yeah, great stuff, Danny. Lots of exciting stuff happening at Cotula. Thank you so much for being here with me today.
Thanks for having me. Hope to see you out on the trails this winter.
Yes, for sure. And thank you, everybody, for watching this episode of First Look. You can catch lots more First Look videos at snoozenet.com.